RVing is fun and easy, especially once you know what you're doing. Hey, I'm Ian Baker, and in this video, we're gonna break down one of the most essential aspects of RVing, how to connect up a weight distribution hitch to safely tow your travel trailer. The last thing you want is to stress out while driving because of a swaying trailer or unbalanced tow vehicle. And the proper installation, setup, and adjustment of your weight distribution hitch will provide you with a safer towing experience and a less stressful travel day. A weight distribution hitch, also called a load equalizing hitch, redistributes the tongue weight across all axles of the RV and tow vehicle so both are as level as possible while driving down the road. You see, too much weight on the hitch will make steering difficult because of the drag on the rear wheels of the tow vehicle. And too much weight on the rear of the RV could cause the trailer to fishtail. When you purchased your weight distribution hitch, the dealership most likely installed it for you. If not, then head to your local dealership to have it installed, as the initial installation is beyond the scope of this video. Plus, you need a wrench like this, which, let's be honest, most of us just don't own. With that being said, let's walk through hitching up and adjusting a trunnion-style weight distribution hitch. The first step is to actually read the instructions that come with your weight distribution hitch. I know it's not exactly a page turner, but it is very important so you can adjust your equipment properly for the specifications of your tow vehicle and RV. Your RV should be parked in a level position with its wheels chocked. Then, balance any cargo inside the RV across the axles from front to rear and side to side. Also, make sure your tow vehicle's parking brake is set. I've seen rollaway vehicles and it's never pretty. Next, use a tape measure to record the beginning height of the tow vehicle and trailer. On your tow vehicle, measure from the ground up through the axle and to the top of the wheel well. Repeat this on both sides of the front axle and rear axle. Then, measure the front and back of the trailer on both sides and make a note of all these numbers. After you hitch up your RV, you'll re-measure to confirm whether your rig has achieved proper weight distribution and, if needed, make adjustments. After that, inspect your hitch bar, also called shank, and ball mount assembly, also called a hitch head, for wear out, missing parts, and loose hardware. These components should have been connected during the installation setup. Insert the shank with ball mount assembly into the rear receiver tube on your tow vehicle, then insert the hitch pin and secure it with the clip. Depending on the manufacturer, the hitch ball should rest anywhere from 3/4 inch to even 3 inches above the top of the trailer coupler. The acceptable height range is listed in the weight distribution hitch manual, which once again is why it's important to read it. Next, you'll want to grease the hitch ball to reduce wear out from function. You can pick some up at your nearest Camping World store or online at campingworld.com. After the hitch ball is all lubed up, you'll use the trailer tongue jack to raise the coupler high enough for the hitch ball to dock underneath. For the next step, a spotter or backup camera will help save you some time and headache. You want to release the parking brake of your tow vehicle and carefully back up until the hitch ball is underneath the coupler. Then, set your tow vehicle's parking brake again. Next, use the tongue jack to lower the trailer coupler onto the hitch ball so that it latches. Then insert the secure latch pin. Once attached, use the tongue jack to raise the trailer tongue and rear of the tow vehicle to remove weight from the hitch. This will make the next steps far easier. For this next part, the spring bars should already be adjusted for the proper height and the lift chain link should already be attached from the installation setup. The snap-up brackets should also already be installed. Inspect all these components for wear out, missing parts, and loose hardware. Next, you'll want to put some grease onto the spring bar attachment points to be inserted into the hitch head assembly. Then insert the spring bars into the hitch head assembly. Put the bottom knob of the trunnion in first and rotate it up so the top knob moves into place through the entrance slot. Then swing the spring bars into position parallel to the trailer frame. Position the snap-up bracket yoke parallel to the ground. Slip the closest chain link over the yoke hook and make sure the lift chain is not twisted. There should be a minimum of 5 chain links between the hook and the spring bar, as less than that will cause the snap-up bracket to bind against the spring bar. Slide the snap-up bracket lift handle over the yoke and raise it up to snap the chain and spring bar into position. The spring bar should be parallel to the trailer frame. Secure the yoke with a locking retainer pin and remove the lift handle. Then, repeat this on the other side. Make sure the number of chain links in between the spring bar and yoke hook match on both sides. Next, lower the trailer tongue so the weight rests on the hitch and raise the tongue jack out of the way. The trailer and tow vehicle are now hitched up using the weight distribution hitch. Lastly, let's verify whether we achieved our goal. Remeasure the tow vehicle and trailer. The hitched up measurement difference from the original measurements should fall within the range listed in the weight distribution hitch owner's manual. If that number does not fall within range, you'll need to adjust your hitch. Reach out to your local Camping World for assistance, or if you're a Good Sam member, you can call the Tech Advisor line for support. Assuming the measurement difference lands between the acceptable range, that means the weight distribution hitch is good to go. Next, hook up your safety chains by crisscrossing them under the coupler. The crisscross chains form a cradle for the trailer tongue to fall onto if anything caused the trailer to disconnect from the tow vehicle. The chains should have slack, but they should not drag. The slack should be significant enough to allow for sharp turns. Attach the breakaway brake cable to the tow vehicle in a spot separated from the hitch head, hitch receiver, or safety chain attachment point. Any of those attachment points could cause failed activation of the breakaway cable. Connect the trailer electrical cable to your tow vehicle and test your brake lights as well as turn signals. Lastly, do a walk-around inspection and touch points on your hitch setup to make sure all pins are fully engaged. The hitch pin, coupler pin, bracket locking pins, and if your setup has some spring bar pins, it only takes a few minutes to verify that all the pins are pushed in place. Double check to make sure the tongue jack and stabilizer jacks are completely up, and finally, remove the wheel chocks. Now you're ready to safely hit the road for your next destination. Thanks for joining me, folks. I'm Ian Baker. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you subscribe. That way you can see all the up-to-date how-to and troubleshooting information.